Hi everyone, in this RPA tutorial video, I'm going to talk about SAP automation using keystrokes. Automation anywhere, we can automate SAP in different ways like using MetaBot. So similarly, we can automate SAP using the keystrokes and other commands like object learning. So those who are new to this channel, I have already created some videos based on the SAP automations like using MetaBot and what is MetaBot. So all those details I have already explained and uploaded those video in my channel. So in case if you want to know more about SAP, you can refer to this video's description section. So from there you will get the details about my previous videos. So now let me go to the SAP and the automation anywhere. I will show you how we can automate SAP using the keystrokes. Okay. So let me explain you something more about the SAP before going into the automation anywhere. So this keystrokes and the object learning options is not reliable, and the success rate is also not very high. And one more reason is like, you know, this keystrokes and object learning, if you use in SAP automation, your automation speed would be very less compared to MetaBot and the scripting method. So in case, let's say if you're working with the SAP and you want to automate using script recording or the MetaBot, then that type, you know, script recording and playback options should be enabled. If it is not enabled, then you have to automate SAP using keystrokes. So in this scenario, you can see here, this script recording and playback is showing as disabled. So I will use a keystrokes and the other commands which can support with the SAP to automate this requirement. Okay, so let me go to automation anywhere and we will start developing a small bot. Okay, so here I'm in SAP automation anywhere. So my first step is like I have to write a transaction code here, XK03. Okay, so okay, let me remove this and I'm going to automation anywhere. So here I will use the object cloning to write that T code. Okay, so let me select the page name. So page name is SAP Easy Access. So object cloning will work in some part of the SAP correctly. However, if you see this part, it is selecting this entire window, right? So in case if you want to click on this tool or any other SAP menu, you won't be able to click. So reason behind it, object cloning is not able to capture this required information. It is treating this entire window is a single window. Okay, so you can see here, however, it is working fine with this page, this T code box. So let me write the T code here. Okay, so I will put the details here like set text, and I will put the transaction code as XK03. So after writing the T code, I will use a keystroke to click on enter. Here I will select the box and I will insert a enter key. Okay, so make sure while using keystrokes and the object learning here, you are putting the proper delay, otherwise your bot will fail. So let me put a delay of 2 seconds. All right, so let me quickly run this code and we will see whether keystrokes and object learning is working fine or not. Okay, so it got disconnected. Let me log into SAP once again. All right, so I'm running this code once again. So this time it worked fine, right? So now I have to write the vendor ID here. Okay, so let me copy a vendor ID. So, okay, let me show you whether we are able to use object cloning here or not. So let me go to object cloning. And we will get the window name is display vendor. Okay, so let me refresh and I'm selecting display vendor in the CV screen, and I'm using to capture. Now you can see here, this object cloning is not able to capture this vendor box where I'm supposed to write the vendor ID. So it is selecting entire vendor. So here we can only use the keystrokes. Okay. So let me remove this. Now I will use keystrokes to write down the vendor details. This is the code which I want to write there in vendor ID. Again, I'm putting 2 seconds of delay. After that, I'm going to SAP, and you know, let's say I have given this number, then I have to use a shortcut key F7. So this F7 will select this. After that, we have to press the enter, right? So I'm again going to Automation Anywhere, and here I'm writing F7. Then I'm pressing the enter. Okay. All right. So let me run this code quickly and we will see whether everything is working fine or not. Okay. So it is working fine. Now the requirement is like, you know, I have to capture this name and this search item. So I will capture two, three values and I will display in a message box. Okay. So let me show you how we can do that. So here we have to use a tab, right? So bot, what it will do, my bot is after pressing the enter, coming here in this vendor number, then I have to use the tab 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So fifth tab will come here. After that, I have to use the shortcut key, control down, shift down, and I have to use the end. Or if you use shift end, it will go to the last part of the details, and after that we can do a copy. So I have given this 5 times tab, so it will go to SAP part. Okay, then okay, but before that I have to change this screen name. So now this screen name changed to a display vendor address. So this is the correct name. Okay, next I have to read that data. So for that I'm going to use a keystrokes shift down, then I will put a end, then shift up. Once this done, I will use control C to copy the value. That I will use control down, C, and control up. So what it will do, it will store the value in clipboard. So I will use a clipboard variable to get the data. So before taking the copy, I will use a clear to keep clipboard options, which can clear any value is there or not. Okay, then I will use a value assign from clipboard. Okay, So we are good to go, and we will see whether bot is able to copy data and storing into variable or not. So let me run the code quickly and we will see. So you can see like we are successfully captured the value from this SAP page using the keystroke. So similarly, guys, you can copy the other available value from here, or you can write values in SAP. So you have to calculate the steps of like, you know, keystrokes. You have to build like, you know, using the proper tab positions and other keystrokes to get the required value, right? So one more thing I want to show you here is like, you know, let me try to read this value once again using the object cloning. So we will see whether object cloning is able to capture that box or not. So I'm selecting this vendor address page. And now here you can see again, this object cloning is not able to capture a single element because of like, you know, SAP is treating this entire Automation Anyway is treating this entire page is a single window. So that is the reason it is not able to capture. Okay. So this is the small task which I have tried to created using the, you know, SAP automation of using the keystrokes and the object clonings. So in case, you know, it's like very easy method, this is also a very easy method, it's like MetaBot. But the thing is that like you have to be careful, you have to put the proper delay, you have to use the correct, you know, a naming convention for the Windows name, otherwise your bot will fail. So similarly, after reading the data, you can write this data into Excel or any other database. So this is all about from this SAP automation using this keystrokes. In my upcoming videos, I will definitely create a complete project where we can use SAP to read, write value, and, you know, perform other activities like reading from the reading from the Excel and writing into SAP, then getting some output, which again bot is writing into a Excel or any other applications. So I'm going to create a complete project like I did for SAP using MetaBot. Similarly, I will create another projects which will be helpful for you to understand or know the other or the available ways we can use to automate the SAP. I hope you like this video and find helpful to understand the SAP automation using keystrokes. And I would request you to kindly like my video and share with other interested people also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel to get more RPA related videos. Please put your comments and suggestions in comment box. Your feedback is highly appreciated and help me to make you know, other videos better. So once again, guys, thank you so much for your time. And finally, I just wanted to tell you something more about, in case if you need any help and support in terms of RPA related projects, you can contact us at rpa.developers1@gmail.com. We provide also different types of training for, you know, robotic process automation for Automation Anywhere and UI part tools. In case if you want to start your career or if you want to move your career in the world of robotics, you can get in touch with us. We will help you. We will help you to groom yourself. We will guide you to make your career in RPA. Once again, thank you so much for watching this video.